Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today I will be going to a popular makeup salon in Seoul to try out idol makeup. So the first thing I did upon sitting down was trimming and grooming my brows, after which we went through some photos and settled on a look that she thought would suit me. What she recommended was Blackpink Lisa makeup. She thought we had similar features, and so we settled on that and went ahead. She started off with a toner pad to cleanse my skin and prep it for the makeup. She spent quite a bit of time on that, using multiple toner pads as well as moisturizers to prep my skin for the makeup. Unfortunately, I don't know what product she used for the skincare, but there are a lot available online. After which, she applied a thin layer of foundation with a foundation brush. It was a flat foundation brush that she dabbed out with a damp sponge. I think it helps the foundation to apply thinly and evenly across the skin. And I definitely noticed that throughout the day, the foundation did not cake at all. I feel like it has something to do with the method in which they use to apply it. Along with eyebrow pencils, eyebrow powders, she also uses a flesh-toned highlighter to kind of bring angles and light to the areas where on my brows. It was very interesting because she was using multiple colors to draw my eyebrows. I think she used at least three different shades to draw my eyebrows, and she also used like different types of brow products, you know, powders, pencils, and she also finished it off with eyebrow mascara. So she starts on my eye makeup, where she applies a dark purplish pink eyeshadow pot onto my eyes with her fingers. After highlighting my under eyes with a light shadow, she then starts accentuating the creases of my eyes with a brown shadow. This is from Bobbi Brown, if I remember correctly. She uses a brown shadow from Bobbi Brown to line the outer edges of my eyes to start accentuating it, after which she comes back in to curl it. Upon curling my lashes, she goes back in again with a black shadow from MAC Cosmetics, where she used a flat eyeliner brush to start drawing out the wing of the eyeliner. Because she used a black eyeshadow rather than a eyeliner to draw it out, it didn't look as harsh as I expected. So what she did was she used a black eyeshadow to draw out the wing, and then she went back in to line my eyes with a black gel liner. She applied a lash strip that was cut into small pieces individually, bit by bit, so it wouldn't feel too heavy on my eyes. And then she used two different types of mascara to coat my top upper lashes. I think both mascaras have different properties. One was curling and one was to elongate my lash. After curling my lashes, she then used a wooden stick. She burned the wooden stick and used it to curl my lashes. I think it's like kind of to emulate a lash perm. I've seen a lot of people doing that on YouTube. It was interesting to see it for the first time. After curling it with the wooden stick, she then went back in with the Japanese Heroine mascara to line my lower lashes. By the end of the mascara falsies my lashes were looking really long and accentuated like a little doll. I loved it very much. Although I doubt I can replicate it at home, but it was interesting to see how much your eyes can change with just mascara and false lashes. After the under eye mascara, she does go back in with under eye falsies. The under eyes falsies was a total game changer for me. She put it at the front of my eyes to make it look a lot bigger than it actually is. And before that, she also did line my waterline with a reddish brown pencil, as well as a dark brown pencil. She uses multiple products to line my under eye and make my waterline more defined. She then goes back in with foundation. She mixes the foundation with sunscreen to give me extra sun protection and applies a thin layer onto my face with a damp sponge, and goes in with two shades of blush, one from Clinique as well as one from Hourglass, one of their ambient lighting blushes, to highlight my cheekbones. So we're onto the lips. She uses a lipstick from Chanel to go over my entire lip, and she tops it with a glossy tint from PeriPera. And finally, she used a concealer palette to conceal the blemishes that I had on my chin, my cheek, and my forehead before concluding with a setting spray. So I just came back from the makeup shop and I wanted to share with everyone my thoughts on it. It was actually really good. I didn't expect it to be so fast, and the makeup teacher stylist, she was really professional. She was really quick and she was really gentle as well. I didn't feel discomfort whatsoever while doing the makeup. I just put down my hair so you can see the best effect. Yeah, so she recommended that I try out the Blackpink Lisa makeup, and she showed me a bunch of pictures of Lisa. We agreed to go with that and continue on. I really liked the end results. I think it came out really well. So I hope it has been fun for you. I don't know what are the exact products that she used, but I'll try my best to indicate in the videos for products that I do know. If you would like to use or try out the same products, please do go ahead. It's been really exciting. It wasn't too expensive. So if any of you are coming to Korea and want to try out idol makeup, or really just experience getting makeup done professionally by a K-pop makeup stylist, there are a lot of salons, especially in Cheongdam-dong, that you can try out. Most of them are receptive to foreigners. They might not exactly speak English, but you can use translator apps for sure.